Real quick, if you want to be a part of the notification squad and write first on every video, make sure you have the alert set up for my channel so you don't ever miss an upload. YouTube doesn't always send out videos to your sub boxes, so like I said, make sure you are signed up to be alerted whenever I upload a video.
What's up guys, I'm Random Frank P, back with episode 60 of Room Tour Project, the series where we show off the best setups. Our special guest is a zombie unicorn. She's a very popular gamer, streamer, voice actress, so I'm pretty pumped to show off her setup for you all. And as always, we have some great setups planned to show off. So we'll kick off episode 60.
First up from Ryan K in this nice bedroom setup, we have these stacked displays here with the monitor on the bottom and that massive TV as an overhead. With the best of both worlds here, Ryan has a PS4 and a gaming PC, so he can choose to switch it up and go towards console gaming or PC gaming whenever he wants. Now first off, his huge black desk is an IKEA Linman, and he also has the IKEA Signum underneath to keep his cables nice and tidy. Always have to have good cable management. But when talking gear, he's using a 29-inch LG ultra-wide monitor, the 29UM67 model, and that Samsung TV overhead is a 40-inch smart LED TV. I assume for his console gaming, he uses that. As for the rest of his peripherals, he has a Corsair K70 RGB Strafe keyboard, the Corsair M65 mouse on a Corsair extended mouse pad, and he has the Logitech Z200 speakers for his audio. And also on his desk, he has a Kylo Ren figure and a Stormtrooper figure to match that wallpaper. So I like when people do that, kind of match it all together. And now we're going to take a look at his PC, which I am a huge fan of. That NZXT S340 case is definitely one of the nicest out there at just being so simple and looking great no matter what setup you throw it on. Inside he has an AMD FX 8320 with some Fantech CPU cooling, you know, keeping it nice and white as well to match the case. 16 gigs of HyperX RAM in white as well. And an NVIDIA GTX 960. But I'm a big fan of the way you pretty much matched everything here with the white braided cables, and I like that white and black backplate on your GPU to tie it all together once again. So wrapping this one up, again, it's just a really nice bedroom setup, and I like how you have it really versatile so you can either PC game on your ultra-wide monitor or kick back and game on your PS4 with that 40-inch TV. The white and black theme I think is nice, and you have the LED light strip to again match with your RGB products to make it all flow. Now it's not too often we have these closet converted setups here, but I'm a big fan of them because it really shows off people's creativity. And I think this one does a great job at showing that. Now first, if you don't understand, this was probably a double-sided closet that he cleared out and took the doors off of to make his very own setup little nook here. Taking a look, those monitors are the Dell 2415H. Having them all together nicely mounted is going to complete that very nice triple monitor setup. Then for his peripherals, he has the Corsair Gaming K70 RGB keyboard paired with the Myonix Caster mouse on a Corsair extended mouse pad again. And having those two RGB peripherals here, again, can help him match it with that light strip behind his desk. We always see these light strips, and I can never say I don't approve. Now as for his audio, he has the Astro A40 headset, and then mounted above his setup are a pair of the Samsung Studio monitors. And taking a look at his PC, which he had changed from the NZXT H440 into the Fantex Enthu Evolve ATX case, he has an Intel i7-6700K CPU on an ASUS Z170A motherboard, 16GB of Ballistics RAM, and an EVGA GTX 970. However, he does say he's going to be upgrading to a 1080 soon, so I hope we see a future submission again. Like I said in the beginning, I love seeing these converted setups here, because not only does it free up a lot of room in their room as it is, where they have it tucked away in their closet, it just gives them so much creativity and freedom to kind of build whatever they want in their own space. So a great job on this. I like the kind of black, silver, and teal theme you have going on, and I'll always say it, plus one for the plant. And speaking of creativity and freedom, there is nothing better than when I see a setup that has a completely custom DIY desk that was built from the bottom up. Literally, this entire desk was built from scratch, and not only is it a desk, but it's its own kind of unit where it has shelving and everything to it that really is fit to match his entire setup. We have another triple monitor set up here. That center monitor is a Dell S2716DG. It is a 27-inch 144Hz monitor. And the outer two are a Dell S2740L. Pretty much the same thing, again 27 inches, except those are 60Hz. Center one's always gotta have those hertz. A closer look at the peripherals here, we have the Razer Black Widow Chroma keyboard with the Razer Naga Chroma mouse. They're on a very nice, glorious PC extended mouse pad here. And as for the other things on his desk, his headphones are the AKG K712. They are paired with his Amp and DAC, which is the Shit Magni 2 Uber and the Shit Mahdi 2 Uber. Great choice there. You can also see his speakers, which are the Bose Companion 3. And I like how he has it kind of tucked away under that monitor riser there. Keeps it nice and organized, and he has a little phone dock on top. And of course, that's not all. If you took notice to his RGB peripherals, his crazy, colorful themed wallpapers, we're gonna be checking out this insane RGB PC as well. Inside another Fantex Enthu Evolve case, we have an Intel i7-6700K CPU with Corsair H100i liquid cooling. That's on an Asus Maximus 8 Formula motherboard, 16 gigs of Corsair Dominator Platinum RAM, and two EVGA 980 Ti graphics cards. But obviously, what's making this entire PC pop are those LED lights inside from the NZXT Hue Plus. And check out those custom rainbow cables there from Cable Mod for the graphics card and the motherboard. Really looks nice, and again, it's going to fit up with the entire setup's theme of being just completely rainbowed in RGB. So this is just a really awesome setup here, and I gotta give you props again for having this entirely custom built DIY desk and kind of shelving unit here. He has the cutout there for where his PC can go. Some more RGB lights in those shelves where he can show off some things. I know he has like his router and stuff in one. This is just a really, really awesome setup here. I love this custom stuff, and that PC is crazy. RGB for days. Next up is the complete opposite of the last setup. This one is extremely just simple and clean. I always like showing off completely different setups, and having these back to back really lets you appreciate the best of both worlds. The solo monitor of choice here is the LG24GM77. It is a 1080p 144Hz monitor. Again, you gotta have that 144Hz for gaming. And its peripherals are the KUL or KUL ES87 keyboard with MX Brown switches inside, and the Logitech G402 mouse. It's like the younger brother to the ever so popular G502 Proteus Spectrum. And then for his audio, he has the Sennheiser HD451 headphones, which appear to be just plugged into the back of the monitor, which is something the iPhone 7 can't do. And then off to the right is his PC, kept nicely on his desk. Inside the Corsair Air 240 case in white is the Intel i5-6600K CPU with Corsair H60 CPU cooling. That's on an Asus Z170M Plus Micro ATX motherboard, 16 gigs of Corsair Vengeance LPX RAM, and a new EVGA GTX 1070 superclocked graphics card. Definitely a pretty solid build that fits nicely on your desk. And underneath the desk is another case of the emergency cable management here with the IKEA Signum. Could be a little bit cleaner, yes, but at least it's keeping most of the cables and power brick off the ground. Then off to the right of his desk is his nice entertainment setup here, which his PC is also connected to this TV. That is a Panasonic CX700 series 4K TV, so he can either kick back, relax, and watch some TV there, or choose to game or, you know, stream movies from his PC directly to that massive TV. Altogether, like I said, a complete change up from the usual setups we show off here, but I like the simplicity, it looks pretty nice, and this might be the first setup that does not feature LEDs.
Woo! Way too bright.
Hey guys, it's Zombie. I'm here with another fantastic video. It's been a while since you've seen my setup, and it's been a while since I had a brand new badass computer to show off and some other cool stuff. I'm gonna tell you a little bit about what I have set up here, along with in my room. So I'm gonna take you around on a little tour of my room and all of its awesome contents. two 27-inch monitors and one 23-inch. I don't know why I have one 23-inch, driving me crazy too. Don't worry. Two of them are HP, they're all right. The one in the middle is a 27-inch Acer from NVIDIA with G-Sync, 144Hz monitor, all that shit. It's fucking beautiful and it's really good. The other two are... Next, I have a Rode mic stand. Also got the AT4040 mic, which is a standard pop filter. Over around back, I have the Scarlett 2i2 by Focusrite, which is what connects my mic to my computer. Right here, I've got the SteelSeries Wireless H headset. I've had it for a long time. I fucking love it. I love wireless headsets. This one also doesn't bother my head or my ears at all. As far as peripherals, I have SteelSeries Apex M800, which is a hybrid mechanical keyboard. I've also got the SteelSeries CSGO mouse, and it looks like the Marvel Fade. And then I've got the SteelSeries XL Qkai, like giant one, the biggest one that you can get. So I have this little speaker under my monitor I use sometimes. It's a Durham. It's pretty good. Next, of course, I have the DX Razor here. This one is from Raising Money for St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. If you want to donate to a really good cause, please donate to St. Jude. Link down in the description below. They're such a great cause. Seriously, do it. Now for the fun stuff. Huge, huge thank you to Origin PC. I am now part of the Origin PC family. As you can see, there's some really amazing coloring going on, as well as like the case is just cool as shit. But that's not even what's important. What's important is what's inside. And inside this computer is a lot of awesome shit.
In my custom Origin PC Millennium, I have an EVGA X99 classified motherboard, an EVGA 1000-watt Supernova G2 power supply, an Intel Extreme Core i7-5930K CPU, 16GB of HyperX Predator DDR4 RAM, a terabyte Samsung 850 EVO SSD, a 2TB Seagate SSHD, an Origin Frostbite 360 liquid cooling system, and finally, an NVIDIA GTX 1080 GPU. Shoutouts to NVIDIA for hooking up this fantastic new GPU.
But wait, there's more! I got a brand new desk from IKEA. It's called the Beckamp, and they're coming out with a new one, and I wanted to wait, but I also really wanted to have this now for this new computer. Cool thing about this is now I can do streams sitting or standing. Get the fuck out!
I got a couple other things for my room, which are really cool. I got a brand new TV, 55-inch TCL Roku TV 2016 version 4K. I also wanted to make my room look really cool. If you saw under the desk, there are some blue lights, and there's also pink light over here on this side of the room, and I got Philips Hue lights. Got that. I ended up getting Apple TV as well, so I can watch things from my phone on the TV. I'll put all the links to the other stuff that I've got throughout this setup in the description. Be sure to check out Origin PC, check out NVIDIA and their new network, NGN. Super stoked to be a part of the Origin family, and I'm so grateful for NVIDIA and SteelSeries also for sponsoring me. And last but not least, I also got an Elgato HD60 Pro, which is an internal capture card. I have the HD60, which is external, but I really wanted an internal card so I would have no delay at all when I'm connecting my consoles. This is so simple and easy to install. I want to do it right now. I'm going to be working a lot with Elgato soon, so I really appreciate them sending me this as well.
All right, guys, that'll do it for episode 60 of Room Tour Project. Hope you enjoyed. And don't forget to check the description down below where I'll have all the products you saw listed down there for you. Feel free to follow me on Twitter at RandomFrankP. And last, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. Well, I'm Random Frank P. Hope you enjoyed. Have a good day.